Hello, and welcome to our holiday behind the scenes fireside chat exclusive on how the Grinch stole biodiversity. Thank you so much for coming out here to support us today. My name is Doctor.
And my name is Seuss. We hope this will allow you to gain some insight into why we think that biodiversity is not important. People are often misinformed about biodiversity and think that the rising rate of extinctions is detrimental to functions of human society.
So despite the prominence of arguments in support of biodiversity that we see so prevalently today on the media, there are a few arguments supporting the ideas that humans are not entirely obligated to prevent the extinction of species.
And with that, we begin. Once upon a time, there was a man named Charles Darwin. Darwin's teachings on natural selection state that human beings and other animals all develop through the process of evolution. Because of this, Darwin believed in competition between species, and those who thrived and adapted in certain niches would provide fitter offspring.
Did you know that Darwin once made a joke about the four stages of life of man? First, you believe in Santa Claus. Second, you don't believe in Santa Claus. Then for Halloween, you dress up as Santa Claus. And before you know it, you look like Santa Claus.
Yeah, no. Anyways, Darwin's theories can allow us to conclude that humans, as a species, coexist among others and, thus, are peers to other animals. Because of this, they do not have the right to destroy other species, unless it is mandatory for survival.
Using Darwin's argument, it also follows that human beings are not obligated to preserve or save other species.
We are animals that move, live, and interact with within the world, especially in the case of Uncle Jerry, who should definitely stay away from the eggnog this Christmas. Any change brought about by humans should be viewed as natural, not detrimental, unlike Uncle Jerry.
And while our impact may not be the most thoughtful holiday gift ever given, our functions, even those that eliminate biodiversity, are natural to our survival in the order of our society.
For example, cyanobacteria brought oxygen to the atmosphere of the early Earth. As oxygen became part of the atmosphere, many species were not able to adapt and soon went extinct. Just as cyanobacteria brought about the extinction of many species through a significant impact on the atmosphere, humans may also be causing the extinction of other species through their actions.
Rather than being viewed as a detriment to the world, this process and change should be viewed as a natural phenomenon and as a part of the natural cycle of species and their impact on the world.
Have seen the sky clouded with gases, lands flooded by massive oceans and continents ruled by insects and then by dinosaurs. And then eventually saw the emergence of mammals and their brains throughout the world.
And now it sees us. Humans are the next step in the history of the Earth. As we advance further into the era of humans each day, we become the selective pressures of the world.
Because of this, species that are the most fit to survive and thrive with humans will be selected for. Essentially, those organisms and animals that are seen as beneficial to humans are selected for, while others are led into extinction. Humans have become the new selective pressures of the world. Because of this, extinctions brought about by humans should not be viewed as unnatural, but instead should be viewed as a natural part of evolution and selection.
During the holiday season, however, we need to think about giving back and improving our society. Many developing nations and countries and governments around the world are currently not capable of maintaining the biodiversity on the planet. Many do not have the economic and educational resources necessary to understand and maintain their biodiversity. More harm than good could arise out of this due to economies around the world attempting to save biodiversity and unsuccessfully being able to do so.
All species impact economies in one way or another. These impacts can range from beneficial to detrimental, or right in the middle, to be neutral. Oftentimes, a species impacts an economy in all of these ways. For example, tigers can bring tourism, but they also kill important livestock. Grinches steal holiday presents, but eventually expand holiday cheer.
Additionally, some countries may be too impoverished and contain too many species that are near extinction. If biodiversity preservation programs were undertaken in these countries, social unrest could arise in developing areas as people continue to deal with problems of poverty, lack of resources, or lack of holiday cheer. The question in this debate also ultimately comes down to whether or not you would prioritize an animal's life over humans.
That is a very important question that we're finding is being brought up as we preserve snow leopards and they're encroaching on people's societies. Even in more developed areas, as they attempt to preserve biodiversity, these attempts are not sustainable. Certain species, such as the giant panda, are extremely expensive to care for and protect, while offering little to no economic benefit. Such species serve only as a drain on the economy. They're cute, you can claim, but they're evolutionary failures. They cannot survive on their own for long. To save this species and others like it is to counteract nature.
Species that have gone extinct without humans serve only as a drain on the economy.
They certainly do. all the extinctions brought about by humans are not unnatural phenomena that need to be fixed. They are instead a natural part of the life cycle on Earth.
Well, isn't that a jolly thought?
It certainly is.
It is not important to preserve biodiversity as we know it, because it is to oppose natural extinctions if we try and halt nature.
Ethical reasoning that justifies attempting to change nature places humans on a pedestal while attempting to take them off that very same pedestal. Humans do not have any more right to destroy species than any other animal. However, animals often do cause extinctions and eliminate other species. Humans neither have the right to destroy the species nor the obligation to preserve them.
Humans simply have to occupy their right place in nature and follow the world on its course. As humans lead species to become extinct, nature does the same. Biodiversity as we know it matters no more than biodiversity mattered before the extinction of dinosaurs, the extinction of giant insects, or any mass extinction at all.
Humans are eliminating the biodiversity in the world. That's fine. Biodiversity is becoming less and less important. This is the natural process of the world. To say otherwise is to try to stand against the nature.
So to conclude our fireside chat, we have a quote from the wise Dan Losey. All humans really need to survive are corn and cows. And if you would like to check out your local Hames bookstore to find out who the Grinch really is, how he stole biodiversity, and how it led to holiday cheer and improved the lives of many, we highly encourage you to do so. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us.